might be interesting to see what the US team will bring to the, sorry, North America team, because we have some Canadians here there as well. Let's see what they will bring to the table. So, same map, other way around. Goblins right now on attack, Crippled Squad on defense. We can see that Goblins right now have switched their players quite a bit. We have zero Maus right now, where earlier we had quite a few. Full, pretty much full, heavy armor. Players on the one glaive, everyone else on short sword. But we still have two dual blades and two bows. So very interesting in the attack, if they will be able to find their place. On the other end, for Crippled Squad, one musket and a lot of short swords. Seems like these guys like their swords quite a lot. What can you tell us about the units, CB?
Yeah, you can see that non-numerical VS from Goblins, he's a really good Cav player, he's bringing two. But other than that, again, a lot of Berserkers, very interesting. I'm really going to watch and see what they do. On the Royal Legion side, on the Crippled Squad side, we do see the Zekalian Militia again, and only one actually on the Goblin Squad. And there's a couple of Numcons as well as some Gunners, there are Janissaries in there as well. So a bit more range on the Royal Legion side, and a lot of Berserkers, as you can see already here on the Goblin side.
So yeah, seems like Goblins like their Berserkers quite a lot. So considering
sense, right? Goblins, Berserkers, what's the difference really?
Okay, when you put it like that, yes, that's the closest you can get to Goblins, I guess, with the units, right? Maybe other than the Sons of Fenrir, right? The unit who is like, when they run, they look a little bit like some trolls or goblins or whatever. But
if they win, they are Berserkers. If they lose, they are Sons of Fenrir.
All right. Let's play for that. Okay, the game opening pretty similar. Early trebuchet cleaning up the artillery. Attackers having 15 trebuchets, quite a lot at the end, because you cannot use it for the middle stage of the fight. You can use it early on the walls, you can use it later on the last cap point, but other than that, not too much usefulness of the trebuchets, so they are spending or investing a lot of the trebuchets right now to clear as much artillery as they can. And you can see that Crippled Squad, yes, they are using the cannons, but they are not using the cannons that intensively. Or maybe on the other end, Goblins are using their cannons much, much better. Because you can see when Crippled Squad played on the attack, they did not use all these cannons that much. Right now, they are using them very intensively, and seems like all three towers already like 30% towards their way and quite good on health. Here we have 60% on the health, middle tower 50%, the one on the right side is dead, but other than that, quite a few artillery left, unfortunately, on the Crippled Squad. And yeah, one more headshot. Unfortunately, I believe it was Spatio who died to the well-placed shot from the ballista, if I'm not mistaken. And we are right now on the tournament server on the latest patch as well. So ballistas right now are not super sniper accurate. They can have a little bit of randomness to their shots. So this was definitely 99% skill and 1% luck included in this shot. But early on, one death, we'll see if this will bring a problem to Crippled Squad later on.
Yeah, quite so. It was Canadian Cowboy on the ballista. He continues to look for kills on it. Well shot by him. Main gate is reached. I think so far they're grouping up on the right side, but they also on the left side already, right? So
yeah, we will see how Goblins will plan their attack. They have three entries open. Make it four entries open, because the back gate is also open and we can see Critical lurking in the back with just a woodcutter, so I guess this will be easy kill for Patio, but you know, one person occupied will not be able to help on the front line, so good use of the deceptive tactics on the back. Goblins having four entries open, we can see what they will do. Seems like they are lurking around in the middle for the gate. We have not seen so far any gate pushes, so will be interesting to see if those two players with Berserkers will be rushing the back of the defenders. For now, everyone moving through the left tower.
points that are starting to push in, and we can see 1, 2, 3, 4 berserker squads from the goblins. So let's see if they can do a lot. They're on Torbjorn, one of the star players, as well as on Gilichoke. As here, there we have the Torbjorn getting the kill, and I think the goblins are really wrecking it at the front line there as the Star Wars continue to follow them up. But let's look on the right side, because that's where most of the crippled squad is coming in.
Yeah, it seems like crippled squad chosen a very interesting tactic right now for the defense. Interesting in the meaning because they will be under heavy fire of the trebuchets, what is happening right now, and a lot of units, as you can see here, for the brachos and a lot of shields dying to the trebuchets. This is very unfortunate, I guess, because moving from this angle, look, they have like 100 meter of a wall where they are being, where they can be under heavy fire of the trebuchet constantly, and this is happening all over again. So people not noticing, seems that they are not looking to the left side. When you see from a player perspective what's in front of you, you need to focus on your units. It's hard to see as well when the trebuchets are flying in, but you should expect them, and this is a big mistake in my opinion from the defenders. They're going to lose the A point much, much faster compared to previous battle.
Yeah, and critically, it's critical that it's actually rushing in with Kev to the supply, which means that the crippled squad is not going to be able to get any new units, and they desperately need them, which means that we could see the goblins actually rushing to this plus on the right side and only face heroes, basically. As critical does that clean up, and there's some armigers there, but they really need to be quick on getting new units and set up their defenses.
Yeah, Tadamish is still alive here for just a slight moment, but look at the players alive. Only 9 players alive from crippled squad. This is quite problematic, and they are not going to defend this plus. In my opinion, this is a good decision. They didn't have time and they didn't have players to set up defense over here. Considering Absolutely. This is 14 versus 9, the best they could do. That's unfortunate that a lot of Namcans will die over here. Maybe not a lot, but this one squad will die. Berserkers rushing in. Not even full squad, just half of the squad, so not that tragic. But considering how the previous game went, 11 minutes on the clock and still 1,500 units coming in from goblins. We'll see if the players from crippled squad will be able on the defense to play aggressively enough to close in the pushes of goblins when they want and how they want, so that they will be able to make up for the poor decisions and the losses they did have in the beginning of the fight. You can see the opening trebuchets. Will they keep an eye out for the trebuchets this time?
Kev at the back, but it's getting stopped. This Kev flank was not good.
Mm-hmm. And the trebuchets once more. I think that the crippled squad, the biggest enemy of them is the trebuchets. For now, they lost a lot of units to that. As the attack hasn't started, let's open the stats quickly, so if you could tell us about that.
Yeah, totally. They're losing a couple of units, but I want to point out something interesting on the map again. Critical's going for the other supply, stopping 4 heroes from crippled squad to actually get units, as more heroes from goblins also go to the left supply, splitting up as they start to push in on the right side. Trying to make the big advance, but Sicilian Militia doing their lot of burn damage there. Units, it's actually 70 in favor for the goblins. But let's look at this fight, General.
Yeah, it seems like one cavalry is going to come from the behind to try to put a pressure on the defenders, and then crippled squad defending in the corner where most of the players, most of the teams defend. Very nice cavalry push around the defenders. A lot of units have died for the defenders. Also, 3 heroes died. So this is going to be very, very problematic defense, especially that they have Payan, they have Yuki Hite on the back with the cavalry, and another player, critical, is still there on plus, blocking new units flow, and they don't have too many units. Of course, goblins putting a very high pressure, they risked a lot of damage, and they received a lot of damage to their units. Just a couple pikes, couple shields are left, and not too many units are here on the battlefield. For yeah. The attackers,
there's only 7, 6, or 5 heroes from Crippled Squad alive, and the traps continue to fly in, but there's no units. I don't think they can even get on the point here.
Yeah, they will not be able. As said, just a few units left, but enough to keep Crippled Squad in the bay. So, 2-0.
Interesting game. Very fast. Amazing played by Goblins.
Compared to what we have seen in the first fight, I can see a lot of similarities from goblins. They like to play aggressively, they like to utilize their pikes, their advances, their cavalry in a pinpoint position. So they create kind of a, you know, wide formation, like a wide wall, wide battlefield, and they choose some small gaps in the defense or in the attack of the opposite team, and they just, you know, take this pin and put it in this small opening very heavily. What we can see on the last point with the nice cavalry charge around, this is something that was done very well from their perspective, and this is something that was seen also in the previous game. So very well played. Congratulations to Goblins for 2-0. Very well played. Let's see right now for the statistics screen how the teams went. So Goblins being the victorious team, we can see Payan once more, MVP, taking the spot over here. Congratulations. 1-0-11. Again, good stats and over 114 kills. Most of those, I guess, were done where he had taken his cavalry and was putting the pressure on the back on the last cap. But definitely throughout the whole game, very good play from the player. We can see also Bergliebe, the co-caster from the German team, taking the second spot. Most of those from the capture points, 251 participation, very nicely played. Other than that, 5 kills on non-numerical with longbow. This is quite an achievement. I can imagine that he was also using his units quite well to achieve this score, but 0 deaths on light armor and 5 kills, amazing performance. Yuki Hide on dual blade as well with 4, this is a good thing to mention. On the other end, for crippled squad, we can see just 2 kills. Levanoga and Just One are the only two players who did a one kill, so this is interesting statistic. Most of the players have died 2 times. We have seen 2 players who died 3 times, so they fought till the end. Unfortunately for the units, it doesn't look too good. We have a couple of players who killed just a couple of units. Most of the other players were around 40, 50, 50 maximum or 63 maximum, 65 maximum. Average, I would say, is around 35-40, so quite a different performance coming out from these two teams when combined. So, Stevie, what did you think about the game? And if you could tell us about the post-game analysis.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, this says quite a bit, right? There was one really big push, and actually it lasted till the end of the game. Goblins saw an opportunity, and Royal Legion were slow to react to the supply interrupt from Critical, which was really critical for Goblins to win this game. And he did it again at the end, amazingly played by him. I mean, absolutely amazing. I'm surprised he's not MVP. He should be. He's on my list MVP for this game, because he screwed up all the plans that Crippled Squad had and did make them look like a cripple in this game. You could see that at the beginning, I mean, the units lost weren't even that bad for Crippled Squad, but they just weren't able to get new units in time. They weren't able to get in the right place in time to defend. And Goblins just kept flanking from 2-3 different sides. And like you said, they put in the needle and they push it through, but they also put in all kinds of different needles and just keep pushing on, and just very convincing win in this one. And I hope we can show it with the clips as well, how well they played. Tell me if you got them ready, because
yes,
I definitely want to rewatch those.
Well, we are ready with the first clip you have sent me.
Excellent.
And let's go into that immediately, because I can see only 2 clips.
Yeah, I just sent the other one as well.
The last one is not correct link, I guess.
I will resend it then, but we can start the first one.
All right, so for the first one.
All right, yeah, this was the first push, and I zoomed in on my own screen because I'm going to look at it here as well, and the Berserkers were really punishing a lot of the units here for Goblins. They really allowed them to push in. You can see Lanzknechte, they tried to race, but they were too late to charge. The traps, not that good at the start. And look at this crippled squad, they have to come a long way from the right. So this means that Goblins was fighting like 10v5 maybe for quite a long time. And then the left flank was basically gone. They started pushing them away. And now the right flank is engaging. But look at this. Pretty clear trap position. You can see Berserkers from Crippled Squad. They get caught by the pikes. And they are just not able to do any damage. And then this trap cleans up the shield wall. And this means goblins can start pushing in. But it's after this that we will see in the next clip that it starts to get really interesting. And look at this. I'm surprised that Crippled Squad kept standing on the A point to, I don't know, like, stall it for a couple of seconds, but they need new units. If we've seen it in all these games, you need to get new units as quick as you can.
Yeah. Well, that's definitely a problem. And here we jump to the second clip.
Yeah. And right here, maybe later we can do it with a sound, but here we can see Critical. He is on the supply, and look how long he's there. I mean, it's 4-5 heroes, 6 heroes fighting him. And that's the advantage of being a short sword. We could see it in the pre-game selection that there's a lot of short swords, and maybe they already had this in mind because they did it again and again and again. And goblins can start pushing down, and we could see Cripple Squad. They had to run because they already lost 6 players, and they were not in any position to defend this supply anymore.
Yeah, so definitely the best decision in the worst time, right? To give this up, but right now we are jumping to the third clip.
Yep. And right here we could see that Cripple Squad, they were kind of in position, but then goblins started to do their thing. You can see them on the right side of your screen. They're already on a supply, annoying enemy heroes from Cripple Squad. They are then starting to push in, but they're also in the center, starting to come in with Cav as well to flank. And this is just going to be too much for Cripple Squad. In this front line, you could see they're still doing pretty well. They're throwing their Sicilian bombs in, doing a lot of flame damage. But they do not have their full squad there, and Cav is coming in. This is too much. And Crippled Squad is slowly getting run over. And we could see that they lost too many heroes, too many units. And they just kept coming in one by one. Didn't work too well for them. And great punish by goblins. In the way that they played this, really well played, very convincing on the attack. I think that this map, and we can do it later for the discussion, but this map was considered to be in favor for defenders because of the supply that is positioned, especially the supply that's closest to the wall. But we have seen that goblins are very efficient at attacking on this map.
Yeah, and for me, one thing we have seen right now here, I believe this is from Payan, not sure who's Cavalry is here, but for me this is like the MVP play for the whole group stage, I believe. Uh-huh. Just look at this cavalry coming in here from the corner. This one, yeah, I believe this is from Pionas. It's following him. Look what he did. He can notice a lot of pikes being set up over here. Of course, his team is pushing, attacking, taking their attention. And look where he goes in a straight line, just behind everyone. Out of the range of everyone and everything, coming here to the back as much as he can. Most of the pikes have died by this point. Only some pikes are still left here, and he's charging right into the face of the all damage dealers and the backline for the defenders. We can see Namkans here. We can see as well some smoke over here, meaning that there were some arquebusers. I'm not sure how many, 2-3 squads, who knows, but with this one charge, pretty much all the damage that Crippled Squad have prepared was taken down in a matter of 2 or 3 seconds. So very, very good. This is how you should use your cavalry units to the max. And this is purple cavalry only, so good job.
Yeah, very.